Welcome to WebStylePress. If you are new here, consider subscribing and hit bell icon. If you take a look at video embed code from YouTube, you will observe its iframe that has got an inline style for width and height for video. So this is iframe code, and you can see width and height in it. Inline style. Inline styling is not responsive. This video, if you embed it in web page, will have specific static width and height that will not respond according to different devices. To make this code responsive or to make this video responsive, you will have to remove width and height from embed code or iframe code and apply some styling to it. I will show you how can you make YouTube videos responsive in web page. This video will auto adjust its height and width proportionally as you decrease or increase screen size. We will use Twitter Bootstrap to make video responsive, and then I will show you how can you make video responsive without Twitter Bootstrap. First, let's create our HTML page. And I don't need this code here. I will need a custom.css here for my custom CSS code. I'm using a CSS file that will be converted into this .css file on save. I'm using Visual Studio Code's extension to do that. And then I will use Twitter Bootstrap. This is Twitter Bootstrap's CDN link. So this is my web page, and we will need here let's use container, and inside container we will copy and paste this code. This is the output for this video, and as you can see, we've got this width and height in this iframe, so this is static. Because of that, this video is not taking full width available here. If you go to Twitter Bootstrap and search embeds, you will see this thing, aspect ratios. Here you can see many recommendations based on aspect ratio that you can choose from. I like 16:9, this aspect ratio. So I will use this. And I will enclose this iframe inside this div. And we have linked Bootstrap already with the document. Let's refresh our page. And now, as you can see, this video has taken up all the available width here. And if I click at inspect, and if I click at this toggle device toolbar, and then if I will resize this screen, is resize this window, this video will respond, and it is now responsive. Its height and width are decreasing or increasing based on size of the web page. So this video is responsive now. And we have used Bootstrap, Twitter Bootstrap, to make this video responsive. And now you don't need this width and height. I am removing these width and height. Save. Let's refresh the page. And as you can see, video is still responsive. So the question is, how will we do without Bootstrap? If we are not using Twitter Bootstrap, how can we make this video responsive? For that, let's use this embed responsive class and create our own styling for that. We will take inspiration from this Twitter Bootstrap code, and let's inspect this page. And I have got this container and then this embed responsive. Let's copy this code that Twitter Bootstrap provides. So it's got position relative, display block, width 100%, padding 0, and overflow hidden. And then, as you can see, this we have got this pseudo element. Before, so let's copy this and paste it here. So pseudo element before pseudo element for this class has got this property: padding top 56.25%. And then we have got something more: display block and content. And also, let's use this box sizing border box. Save. And then inside it, we have got iframe. For iframe, we have got the styling. Inside this class, we have got iframe for video that has got this. So iframe has got position absolute, top, bottom, and left are 0, width 100%, height 100%, and border is equal to, border is 0. So this is our styling that we copied from Twitter Bootstrap to make video responsive, and we are using this same class. Now we are going to remove the Twitter Bootstrap from our code. Twitter Bootstrap removed. This Twitter Bootstrap, the style sheet, CDN link was removed. Now it is linked with our custom.css. That is this custom.css generated by this custom.scss. And we have got this class embed-responsive. Inside it, we have got iframe, and we have got this CSS file. And let's see the result. And we have got this video now. So we don't have a container now. So this video is taking up full width, full available width of the web page. And let me inspect this web page and click at the here toggle device toolbar. And let's decrease or increase size of web page. And as you can see, this video is responsive now. It is responding to the available width. Perfectly responsive without Twitter Bootstrap. Although we have copied responsive embed code from Twitter Bootstrap, we can just take that code and use it in our CSS and make it our own. And in case you're not using Twitter Bootstrap, you can still use this piece of code to make videos responsive. Now all you have to do is to use this embed-responsive class as a container class. Use a div outside this iframe. Use this embed-responsive class. Use iframe inside it. You don't need width and height with that iframe. And you can use these CSS classes, and that's it. The video will be responsive. use iframes, use as many videos as you like. Just use embed-responsive class with outer div to this iframe and your video will be responsive. And you can of course explore more aspect ratios from here. Go to Twitter Bootstrap, search embeds, and you will find something like this. We have used, I like this one, 16 by 9 aspect ratio. Right, so it recommends that you use embed-responsive-item with the iframe, but we have targeted iframe directly. So we do not need this class. So by using this technique with the Twitter Bootstrap, it is really easy. All you have to do is to use this div with these two classes, embed-responsive and embed-responsive-16x9, and use iframe inside that, and video will be responsive. Or you can use same code from Twitter Bootstrap to make videos responsive if you're not using Twitter Bootstrap. Very easy. I hope you liked this video. If I missed anything, comment down below. If you haven't already subscribed, subscribe to this channel and hit bell icon to receive updates. Join us on social media. Links are in the description below. Stay tuned for more updates. I will see you in the next video.